If it was the same tone as Toy Story, then it would be like, it's Toy Story in space. I feel like the education I've gotten from Pixar is really incredible in that, you know, I've been there for 25 years, and now with Lightyear, it's the first feature I've solo directed, but it's all of the things that I've had the benefit of learning from that time that allowed me to make the movie. I did a series of shorts and I learned on the short films, but I also, as an animator, learned the process of the animator to be at the studio during the unprecedented level of success that they've had has afforded me a lot of learning. And I would say it's been a safe place to be not great and then learn how to be less not great, better, better.
Yeah.
I could just say
double
better.
Negative. Less
it's a
not.
Double negative.
Yeah.
What about you? Galen was already great.
But oh,
then
yeah,
she,
that's
but she, she started great. See, I started less great.
So
Galen, take it away.
So not true.
Take it away.
I started Pixar as I started Pixar as a generalist in our commercial division. So that meant that sometimes I would produce and sometimes I would direct and sometimes I would animate, sometimes I would do technical stuff. It was crazy. Very flexible time. And then when we started doing feature films, I had to specialize. And I was technical, so meaning modeling, shading, lighting, and effects, basically, for many, many years. And I can't think of another place that would have allowed me to learn everything that I learned about the filmmaking process hands-on and then switch and become a producer, which it's so much more manageable, I think, when you understand exactly what it is, how we make our films. I think I would find it very difficult to produce if I didn't have that in-depth understanding of how the films get made.
Yeah, that's a really, just to put a fine point on that, like, if I have a strength as a director, it's that I know what it's like to be on the ground as an individualist, and I think I really depend on that feeling.
Absolutely.
The connection to Toy Story is more of a jumping off point. And I wanted to have the film be enjoyable in its own right with limited connections to Toy Story. It was not a Toy Story movie. It was meant to be, I just wanted to make a sci-fi action movie that I thought was awesome with Buzz Lightyear. And so with using the character Buzz Lightyear and trying to get down to like what would that kind of movie actually be for itself? What's the story that we want to tell? It's less of a journey of emotional truth, although you have part of that, and then more of a discovery of what is the kind of movie that you're expecting from this, and how do you make that movie but better? You're making a movie more than like that. It's kind of the movie over the profound statement of like staring into your soul of humanity, which is usually what Pixar makes. This is a little bit more of a let's have a good time in the movies than like oh my gosh, I'm realizing. Rethinking my priorities and I'm going to call my mom. Like, it's not that kind of story. So that was really what we were trying to do, was find a way to make something that was an entertaining ride and something that we would have loved to have seen at like age 10. And we weren't really interested in repeating the tone of what we'd done before. Because if it was the same tone as Toy Story, then it would be like, it's Toy Story in space. That's been challenging to communicate in the marketing, but ultimately it is the movie is self-contained. I think the tone of it is we need to care about the character and we need to put that character through a bunch of difficult situations. We need to believe in that character but see the character go through growth. And then at some point there's got to be lasers and spaceships. And so you're really balancing.
In a zero gravity fight.
Yeah, you're like, what do we want to see? You got to see Buzz and Zurg got to fight. Some sort of zero gravity thing. There's going to be some spaceships and lasers. So you're always juggling all of these elements to see what comes together and what's fun.
It's a very interactive film, for lack of a better word. What we found when we finally got to see it in a theater with a large audience is that there's something about the energy of how people respond to the film as they're watching it that is really, it takes it to another place. It makes it that much more enjoyable. We also made the film very cinematic, very tactile, so that it can be an immersive experience. We want people to be able to go in, sort of lose themselves in space and really then enjoy the story that they're experiencing while they're there. And it's hard to lose yourself in an image that's this big.
The tremendous popularity of Buzz Lightyear is something that's novel and it's intimidating, but because we've worked on this character so much, we aren't looking at it from a standpoint of like, oh no, don't break the fine china. Like we're used to taking that china and juggling it and breaking some pieces and gluing it back together. That was a weird analogy, but I think it.
Yeah.
So yeah. We were less concerned about that, more just wanted to make an awesome movie, and we're super pleased with the results. So. Yeah.